This is it. Are you ready for it?
I guess as ready as I'll ever be.
We don't have any answers as to when we're ever going to get back into our home. This is it, guys. This is reality. Right here is our home and everything we own, and we had to pack it into this thing right here.
It's like stressful. This sucks.
I do miss our home. I mean, for sure.
The tread pattern has like worn down together. It is completely smooth here.
It's crunch time here in the Hanks household. We have less than a week left until our home on wheels is going in for service. And yeah, there's a lot that needs to be done. Aside from Carl doing so much editing and thinking about our home being away from us, like first of all, we still don't know where we're gonna stay. We'll figure it out. But hey, calm down.
Calm down, just relax a second, okay?
Let's do one thing at a time here. What I'm gonna do today is clean the fridge. Each day, we're gonna go little by little and kind of clear the RV out, because in order for them to work on the RV, they're gonna need stuff out of it.
Full advantage of being in Michigan, hanging out with friends that know what they're talking about when it comes to technical findings. So we're on top of the roof here, and we are noticing even more damage than what we initially found. It looks like the coils on the backside here are all bent. The whole framing of the AC is bent. There's metal making contact with the rubber roofing underneath. Also, a couple more things that we notice is that the roof itself is actually having increased flexing and buckling whilst walking on it. This thing could still be totaled.
I totally don't know though.
Another thing we noticed is on this kitchen slide where most of the damage occurred, the screw heads on top of the slide are wearing through the actual tape. So there's increased wear, concerns for alignment, and other things when sliding in and out. Add it to the list of things that are potentially wrong. I tell you what, it's just one thing after another. I would recommend if you're ever in this situation, take full advantage. If you have friends that are more inept with understanding how things work, design, engineering, electricity, whatever it may be, get some extra set of eyes on it and really take a walk through and break down things piece by piece. While you're doing so, make sure you take lots of pictures and write out like a Word document or on a piece of paper your findings as well. Dude, those pancakes are looking banging.
Oh yeah, and it's only lunchtime, so it's fine.
What do you guys call lunch in the North? Is it brunch, lunch, supper, or dinner? Throw your comments below.
That depends on the time of the day.
Yeah, that's true.
Correct me in the comments if I'm wrong.
Like always.
In the South, dinner is supper and lunch is dinner. Am I right or am I right?
I don't know. You don't have to yell at us. A couple episodes back, Dee got her tires changed. She got some fresh kicks, and I figured today I want to take full advantage of being settled down at a spot and utilizing some resources that I don't have while living full-time on the road. Simple tools like an oil pan. Yeah, it sounds silly, but it's so nice to be able to change your own oil while out on the road. If you guys are also full-time on the road or even part-time, how do you guys manage changing out oil and doing routine maintenance on your tow vehicles? Kind of one of those people that like to just take it to the dealership and get it all done at one time, paying for that convenience. Hey, I can't blame you for that. Or do you like to sit at home, kind of get your hands dirty and take advantage of just crawling under and being out one with the machine? Bit left in here, top her off the rest of the way, and then I think I can call it a night with D. I think seriously, she's been kind of needy lately, so glad you're here. Thank you for all your love and support. Honestly, without you guys, Happily Ever Hanks would not exist. No word of a lie. We are at the Grand Design factory here, and they have hooked us up, or anyone that owns Grand Design, they offer all these full hookup sites, so you can just come in, swing in here, even on a weekend. Today is a Sunday. Our appointment is 8 o'clock in the morning tomorrow, Monday morning. We are here because a tree fell on our RV 2 months ago. We finally made it here. All of you sitting out there saying, yeah, this is exactly what I'm worried about with buying an RV. You should be, because this is the way life works. You gotta dust the dirt off the pants and you gotta get back out on the road.
Cause it's like stressful. It sucks.
But we're a good team. We're the Hanks family.
I know.
And we got a kid to take care of. Dexman's our child and he needs us right now. So we gotta stay strong.
I know.
Roll with the punches and dust the dirt off. You know what? I want you to stop right now. Don't even move. Now I want you to look down. Seriously, look down. What does your shirt say? Practice what you preach. That's what I'm saying. So you say choose to be happy and you're telling everyone that all this stress comes. You know what?
Positive vibes.
Bring those positive vibes because you're Nene and you're always happy. Do what Renee's shirt says and just choose to be happy. She's feeling down. I'm feeling energized because listen, we're here. We made it. No additional damage has happened. There was no blowouts along the way. There was no salt in the wounds. So I'm gonna do my best to uplift her and make sure we take off some of that stress. And that's exactly how a team works. You always, always help uplift one another, and that's what we wanna do for you guys. We believe in you and we love you guys. Let's get the sucker unhooked. I say let's get some din-din on the grill and then we'll come up with the game plan and we'll get this puppy unloaded and then we'll take on tomorrow.
Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it, sister. Love it. I love you, babe. And I love you guys. Dude, I think you're getting a little heavy for that. What happened out here?
I went to lift the cage up to take him inside and just...
You're kidding me. I just got done saying we had no bumps in the road, but here you go. RV life at its best, I'm telling you what. At least this didn't happen down the road. All of a sudden, she's like diving out for Dexter, like holding on for him for dear life.
He
she's
was
like,
free.
I know.
I was like, if you run around and get lost at Grand Design.
Oh my goodness.
And become their new mascot.
He was like reaching for the door because he knows where home is. He's like, fancy feast. You were just like total mom move. You're like, whoom. Do you have anything to say for yourself? You just don't even care.
Meow. Who's this in the truck for hours? Meow. Meow. Meow.
This family is messed up, I'm telling you what. You know how much I love you? So much. So glad you guys are here. I broke Nene's ankle. Oh, stop it. Now she's putting on a show because she's like...
I hope as we lay here that somebody has picked up after their dog.
I hope everyone's using those doggy bags. I mean, so far you look good. But I don't know about me. I feel like Grand Design's going to kick us off. They're going to be like, get out of here.
Yeah, why are you laying
crazy
in the grass?
Hooligans. Hashtag RV life. Look at somebody just parked their camper right in the middle of the road here. Who does this? Well, let me ask you, what do you think we're gonna have to unload actually in the RV? Like packed up and out of there?
Like that whole back wall and the...
The rear cabinet?
And the kitchen slide area.
Okay, like all the dishes and everything?
Yes.
While I have you guys here, I did want to mention something that I found at the truck stop today, and I'm really glad I did a walk around. A lot of you guys have been asking, do you guys have tire pressure monitoring system on the RV? And no, we do not. We check them every day before we go, and a lot of you have been giving us really good feedback and saying, well, it doesn't matter when you're out on the road, things happen quickly and fast. And those TPMS systems really help to give you awareness of when things go downhill. And you can see right here that the tread pattern has like worn down together. It is completely smooth here. It got me thinking maybe there is a loss of camber in the actual axle that these are on. I'm gonna have Grand Design take a look at it while we're here as well to address it, because I don't wanna go taking off another tire, putting a brand new one on, and then running into the exact same problem.
I want to address before we get back out on the road and buy new tires. So I'm glad we made it here safely. How many of you get sick of doing this where you're just like walking around like this? This is like the walk of the RV life. It's just like, did you check tire pressures? Did you hook up the water? Like this is the story of my life right here. Probably a good few people wondering like, what is wrong with this guy? Let's get back inside before people start being like, get them out of here. All right, what's going on? You're already digging into the chocolates. Honey, we gotta get some work done here. Where'd all this come from? Oh, this was from the meetup yesterday. Oh my, okay. Is it good? I feel like your shirt should say, choose wine. You're a wine head, you know that?
But isn't that the same thing? Choose wine, choose happy, isn't that?
It goes hand in hand. Tell me what you're feeling right now. Is this like super stressful or what?
I'm actually having fun.
No, you're not. We just got down, when we got out of the truck, you're like, now you're like, oh, I'm having so much fun. Oh, tongue in cheek, huh? Story of my life, tongue in cheek. I love you.
I love you.
Can't have anything nice in this family.
Oh, I forgot to put pillowcases on these.
We don't even use those pillows, are
they? No, our spare, guys, back me up on this. Even though you have your pillows, you gotta have spare pillows. And what if you have guests and what if you just need extra pillows?
Guys, back me up on this. How many times do we keep extra pillows just to not throw pillowcases on them and then we just travel everywhere with pillows?
You wanna do this right now? Hold on, let me just mute the audio real quick.
Okay.
I think if you're ever in the situation where you need to pack up and you need to pack up fast and there's just so much to do, eat an elephant one bite at a time. And what we mean by that is just take it into small bites. Don't think about the whole picture, just think of one thing at a time. And then once you accomplish that, go on to the next thing. It's super simple, but it really helps lower those stress levels, if you know what I mean. It's stressful right now, and this sucks moving out of our home. But we're moving into an Airbnb. Gotta count those small wins. At least we're gonna have amenities, and Dexter's gonna have a roof over his head. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna eat an elephant one bite at a time. Eat an elephant one bite at a time. So yes, it is stressful. It sucks. Tomorrow morning is gonna be a wake-up call. We're gonna have to wake up early. We have no idea what to expect, but guess what? We're gonna get through it together, and we are so glad you guys are here. If you have ever had to move out your camper for an extended period of time, like you got some work done on the camper, and they're like, hey, hit the road and leave the camper here, throw it in the comments below. Help us feel a little bit better about our lives right now. We need to hear from you guys. I can't hear you right now, and the only way I can hear from you is in the comments, so I'll be looking out for you. You better be there. Oh, okay, I see you now. We're all good. I'm so glad you guys are here. A lot more peaceful out here now, huh? Y'all grab the beers. Meet me over here. Starting a fire at 7. Oh, you locked your wife in the pass-through as well? Classic. She's sturdy.
Are you ready to tackle the inside? Come on.
Dude! This is where you've been the whole time? Thanks for the help, man. Okay, you're just trying to play the cue card right now. Okay. Oh, yeah. Everyone's just eating it up there, Dexter. Just keep it going, bro. It's not working for Dad. No, I know what your true colors are. I know what your true colors are.
All the extra space I have down here.
Yeah?
Like, we should just put, like, these plants and all this, like, that are chewed on.
Wait, they're chewed on? Let me see.
What?
Oh, that... butthead. Hashtag stinky butt.
Hashtag children.
Hashtag lots of hashtags going on. I'm happy we went from there to there.
Yeah.
Wow, we are just killing it tonight, Nene.
Yeah, you wanna know Nene's guilty pleasure?
Puzzles. And Disney puzzles at that. What's the game plan?
So what I'm thinking, with important stuff that we wanna break here, and then whatever up there.
Okay. You're not planning on putting stuff up there, are you?
Ooh, good idea. No, the whole roof's probably gonna come off, so we can't do that. So let's go, pass me the dishes.
Gotcha. Oh my gosh, almost done.
We're making progress.
What are you drinking? Because that's surely not water, is it?
No.
It's not water, it's White Claw. Need I say more? Hey, you ready to say goodbye to our home? We gotta say goodbye. You want me to just pick you up in a couple weeks? You enjoy it, babe. Stay strong. It's an absolute mess in here. And we're just trying to keep our heads about us right now because we don't know what we're taking, what needs to be packed up. I mean, we got all those cabinets cleared out, but we don't know how much junk we got to get out of here for these technicians to get in here and get the job done. So I think our goal is to actually walk to the customer service station, talk to them a little bit and get more of an idea. But it's sweet being here with the full hookups and everything because this is right over across the road. So it's perfect. It's not even a road. It's like just like a little... I'm gonna miss it here. Man, you never know what you have till it's gone, right? Maybe it'll be a reprieve to move out and just live like a normal person for once. Who are we kidding? We're the normal people, right? I know. We're not normal. I'm following you. Are you ready to move out?
No.
Sounds like a war zone out here. There are just golf carts. There are forklifts going. Everything's like... There's like... It sounds like... Stuff is getting done, so I think we're in the right place. This place is huge! And we have no idea where we're going.
No idea.
Welcome to Hanging with the Hanks. So we just got an awesome surprise. So what we just found out is all that packing up we did last night, unnecessary.
No, but here's the thing. She said as long as they don't have to take the whole roof off. I think they're gonna have to take the whole roof off. There's a lot of damage to the roof.
What we're mainly getting at is that whole slide comes out as one piece. Everything in it just stays in it. So moving all those pots and pans everywhere and all that jazz was just unnecessary, but it was exciting and it made for a good time hanging out with you guys. So reality step number one is, yes, we just did a ton of unnecessary work last night when we could have been relaxing and trying to get packed up for our real stuff that we're taking to Airbnb. No harm, no foul, but if you ever do need to come take your rig in for some service work, just contact them and make sure they don't need it, but I don't think they do because they just take that whole little sucker right out the side and they call it good.
And it's not raining right now, so let's take advantage of moving stuff in.
And we're working with drill sergeant here. So here we go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. You ready to go on an adventure? Come on, buddy. Dad will show you the way. This is life. Remember what we talked about? Life is so much fun. No, it doesn't suck. This is it, guys. This is reality. Right here is our home and everything we own. And we had to pack it into this thing right here.
It's an adventure, though.
It's an adventure. And you just got to laugh about it and just keep on going, right?
Yeah.